My name is Kirk Brown, and with my wife, Renette, we are teachers responsible for this Vipassana Meditation Center, Dhamma Dipa. We are also local school teachers.
All right, tidy up everything.
Dhamma Dipa is situated near Hereford. Dhamma Dipa means island of truth. It only has one purpose really, which is to teach meditation courses in Vipassana, in the tradition of Sāju Bhākin, as taught by S.N. Gwenkā of India. S.N. Gwenkā is the principal teacher of Vipassana throughout the world. He was born and brought up in Burma, where he learnt the technique of Vipassana from his teacher, Sāju Bhākin. Audio and video tapes and discourses of Gwenkāji's teachings are given on all of the courses, so that there is consistency for all that come.
I think it's wonderful. It just has a positive, calming influence on both of them. And Sam does a lot of meditation at home anyway. So I think it's a great idea.
I think it's quite good. I think it's introducing them to sort of, I don't know, different culture, I don't know, different way of life. Just hopefully more relaxing. Get some out of the school environment for a day. And yeah, I'm just hoping he's really going to enjoy the day as well.
Sam and Lawrence both have Asperger's syndrome, and they can get quite irate, so Sam, more than Lawrence, finds it a very positive experience. He's quite happy to do it, and he knows when he needs to do it, and he does feel sort of refreshed afterwards, comes out a different person.
Right, now I'm more excited than ever, and later on I'll be more excited than ever than I am now.
I'm going to be doing meditation at this place, and I'm going to be doing meditation for about half an hour and quite a few of the stuff, and I think it's going to be very exciting.
I was at Pāli excited last night, so I woke up really early, so I stayed in bed like for like an hour just being excited.
There is a meditation hall. There are some cells for individual meditation. There are accommodation blocks. There are kitchen, dining rooms, those sorts of facilities, a large walking area that is landscaped.
Actually, I'd heard about it from the previous head teacher, who'd said on a number of occasions, oh, our children go to meditation, and my first response was, it's a bit wacky, I'm not sure about that. So when I got the headship, of course, I wanted to go.
Obviously, I was very inquisitive to start off with, and once Mrs. Brown had mentioned what it was about, I thought how wonderful that the children would be given an opportunity to share in something which hopefully could give them the space and time they need to develop their own lives and also their concentration in curriculum time.
We all rush from, you know, job to job, don't we, with never a pause in between. And to actually give children from the age of 8 upwards a chance to just stop and just reflect, really, I thought it was a wonderful opportunity.
When the children come here, they take 5 simple moral precepts or promises they try to keep for the duration of the course.
It's basically to stick to the 5 rules, sticking to the 5 rules that they have at Dhamma Dipa.
One of the promises is that you don't do any killing, really.
not to kill, not to steal, not to use harsh words, and they're about the only ones I can remember.
Abstain from stealing.
Do you want to go first?
Okay. I'll abstain from killing.
And abstain from stealing.
Abstain from misconduct.
Abstain from taking any intoxicants, something like that.
Not to take in any intoxicants.
Is that it?
And there's one more. Doing backbiting and harsh words.
I knew that.
It's important to take the precepts because they are the foundation of the work that the pupils do here. You can't really start to meditate and look inside if your mind is disturbed by rather gross things that are happening in the outer world.
It would probably be very good, to be honest. I do have quite a bad temper, so I think it will really help me cool it down a bit.
Anapana meditation means respiration, to do with the respiration.
On the nostrils and the way that breath is coming in and going out.
First of all, this is quite a struggle. They find many difficulties to be aware of the breath. And gradually the mind starts to calm down. They develop the ability to bring the attention back, first of all, to this area. Of course, the mind keeps getting pulled away. They keep bringing it back. It gets pulled away. They get distracted by different thoughts. And then they bring it back to this area. And gradually, as I say, the mind steadies down, calms down, and they can settle in that area for a little bit of time to develop the concentration of the mind. During the course, the children are checked by the children's course teacher to see how they're doing. Small groups go to the children's course teacher and they meditate for a couple of minutes, and the teacher asks them how they've been doing, what their practice is like of meditation, and they try to discuss any problems they may have had and iron out any difficulties that they've had.
Some of the children who can be quite agitated, you could see those children just really get into the meditation and sit for fairly long periods of time. It builds up over the time they're there. But they were able to be calm, they were away from home, and it was really helpful for them.
It's like a helping hand because, you know, if everything's getting too much for you, some people just don't know what to do. And it's nice to feel like you've got something to keep you up if you really need it.
I think the children find the techniques used in the meditation centre very useful for their lives when they come back into school. They certainly find that it gives them the space and the time they need to have a quiet time, to reflect on what's going on, and to also deal with situations which actually the frenetic pace of life brings to every school day.
The games are really just to give the kids some light relief, really, from the meditation. That's just to get them running around and, you know, losing a bit of energy.
The idea is to play a bit more calmly and gently and to respect the atmosphere of the meditation centre. So we discourage them from playing war games or contact sports.
Go put them somewhere safer.
Well, yeah, play calmly, not much slowness at all. Maybe a little bit wrong, but not really hitting each other, because that is horrid.
One, two, three!
One of the things they've done today is they've made a poster. To make images of what they feel the five precepts or five promises are all about. We did that, and we decorated the tree, as you've seen. Just creative, really. Again, just some light relief.
Children are very used to doing physical exercises to make their muscles strong and to make them physically fit. So they learn that also they need a exercise for the mind that will make their minds strong and fit and healthy. At the end of the course, the children practice metta, practice of loving kindness. They hear a tape by Gwenkaji, and he will be giving new instructions. So the children have found some peace and harmony inside themselves, and now they learn how to share this peace, share this harmony with all beings.
It's wishing people happiness throughout their life.
Wishing other people to be happy and be peaceful.
Father, classmates, people of the country,
brothers and sisters,
brothers and sisters, yourself, and the people of the world.
And your classmates, no, your schoolmates.
Schoolmates, that's all.
A lot of heads are perhaps somewhat reserved at times about giving new things a go because of the pressures from the government and from day-to-day school life, but actually the benefits of actually giving it a go will be evident to them and the children who come back from the course.
Normally before, because Dylan annoys me, stealing all my toys, I feel really angry, so I sit down and do a bit of meditating, and then I feel a lot better, and then I go and ask him instead of go around chasing him.
It makes me feel much calmer as well, much calmer, because I am a quite stressed person, so I like to be calm, and I like to calm myself down.
I think it's the fact that it gives the children a chance to develop control over their own minds, and I think that's a thought that is completely new to them when they go on the meditation course. Up until then, I think they feel it's their mind that runs them.
If I don't like something or I'm a bit cross or something, I meditate to get it out of my mind, and then I'm all right after that.
I think it's really helped me, kind of, because usually I'm quite annoying and that.
I learnt about meditation, how to control your mind.
With the straight back, Owen.
Before I meditate, I feel a bit afraid. When I feel after, I feel a bit happy.